We are outside of York, PA, along the Conewago Creek, where our utilities crews have run a brand new gas main 30 feet under the creek through bedrock. They work together with our site crews, clearing crews, to be able to make this one happen. So to see how this all took shape, we're gonna take a trip back to day one, where we met up with Brett and Brad from utilities, where they gave us a lay of the land and explained how this project was gonna come together.
This is the bore pit here. So the machine will sit up somewhere around this area. They'll take their drill in. It's kind of going on a weird angle, but they'll take the drill in, go down 38 foot below the creek bed. Once they hit the start of the creek bed on this side is where they want to have that drill leveled off. So when they're coming across the creek bed, they can start coming back up. And then once we pull up out, we'll transition from steel to plastic, and then we'll have to cross 74 up on this street, tie in here, just like we're gonna do here. Tie it in, gas the whole line. Once it's gassed, we'll abandon that bridge section.
I haven't been over here since they staked it out. Looks like we're gonna go and build an access road right through here.
Okay.
Right through here, so this is where the clearing's gonna start. When this site division comes in, I've got to start here and start clearing this whole thing, and then they're gonna take dirt from one spot to another and cut and fill in here and make a whole road all the way down the length of the pipeline here. But yeah, that's what you got. For the start, anyway.
Yeah. Brad Herrick, everybody.
Thank you. Okay, that's what we got for you. Wasn't much to start off with.
So we started this job here 2 days ago. This is our second full day that we've been in here. We've got another couple days in here before we move equipment from this side of the creek to the other side of the creek to finish out our line of sight clearing for the bore operation. And then we'll pretty much be out of here and ready for them guys to get in and start the access road. So we've got some finish and cleanup work to do, but we'll get the most of it done while we've got good weather to do it. Our small material is actually getting ground up with our forestry mulcher, and that material is getting scattered across the ground to stabilize the ground until our site guys get in and put this access road in. So if we get rain, this woody material on the ground is going to hold the ground. And our excavator is actually cutting logs and other material out of it that's too big to grind with the forestry mulcher, and that is going to go to our organic recycling facility to get ground for mulch and other wood products that could get used in other ways. So it's all gonna get recycled in one way or another.
Here we are at the bore pit. This is where they set up to drill in about 860 feet of 8-inch steel underneath the Conewago Creek directional drill. They drilled in at this end. We're gonna pop out at the other end, and then we'll back ring three times and then pull the steel pipe in.
So when they put the rods in the ground, they have a head that detects, sends signals up through the ground to a box that a locate guy runs. They can steer, they can turn, they can go deeper or whatnot. That's how they determine where they're at that moment in the ground. And then they crossed over the Conewago Creek. They're roughly 32 feet deep.
Here's one of the runs that's gonna get installed. It's 8-inch coated steel. Utility company come in to weld everything together for us. After that, we'll sandblast it and do a two-part epoxy to protect it before it gets pulled into the ground. So this is one of the areas here that was welded. We'll set up, sandblast this. Everything's got to get collected for DEP. get this all sandblasted off, mix up a two-part epoxy, and we'll cover this whole area here with an overlap to protect it so it doesn't rust away. See, we're set up on the north side of the creek there, where they're set up the back ream. They're pretty much done with the first back reaming process. There'll be a second one and a third one to make sure there's enough room to slide the pipe through without any damage to the pipe.
We are back at Conewago Creek. As you can see, it has snowed, it's cold out, but the crews are still here working. Today is the day. The pipe is getting run underneath the creek from this side to the other side. So it'll be about 8 hours of work pulling it, making the connections, and checking the pipe as it's running through.
After the bore pipe's done, we have some open cut. You can see with the excavator sitting up there, a couple hundred feet, it'll be open cut. It'll have to also get epoxy. Goes up to the street 90s and then goes out to 74 to get tied in.
Today, we got welders out here welding a 90 in to the existing main to come under the road to then be able to tie into the gas line that we have run under the creek. Once that's done, they'll hop up to the other side, tie into some plastic pipe, and then we should be wrapping this one up soon. It is about the last day of construction. Dustin's here to explain a little bit about what we're doing to tie things up.
Today we had two crews here do the last two tie-ins, gas the main, cut the existing main apart, get all the residual gas out, and clean up work after that, and everything's pretty much wrapped up. Guys roughly installed 1,400 feet of 8-inch steel and about 350 feet of 8-inch plastic throughout the project. Everything went well, and I'm sure the guys are happy to move on to the next project.
Perfect. So that is going to wrap this project up here for the utilities crew. Stick around. Our highway and bridge team is going to be coming in and actually rebuilding the bridge that the existing main was on. So we'll see you then. What do you think, Jake? All right.
Perfect. That's a wrap. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.